Oh, Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Father, we thank you for your great mercy and love. We thank you for the gift of your your Son. And we thank you for all that we have, Lord, that we can give. Lord, bless it now, we pray. Use it for your kingdom. Lord, that many men, women, and children will come into the kingdom in America and around the world. We need you at this hour more than ever. And all together we say, amen and amen. Stories proceeded long before they got their first glimpse of him. People had heard about him. They heard the farmers laugh about the herd of pigs that had gone crazy, and the madman who was no longer man. They met a paralyzed man who now walk from town to town without so much as a limp, just to show people that he could. They had welcome home sons and daughters, family and friends, who had been sent away as lepers, but returned home without any sign of the disease. They had been speechless to hear the widow's son, a centurion's daughter, and a man named Lazarus, all who had been pronounced dead, but who were alive and well, telling their stories to anyone who would listen.
Thank you.
as well. He spoke with authority as he offered forgiveness, just as Jesus wanted to be near the people. So God longed for intimacy with his children. No one had heard these words before. No one had offered such comfort and hope.
Thank you.
Let's see how loud we can say that. Hosanna. Come on. Hosanna! One more time! Hosanna! Praise the Lord. Thank you, choir. Thank you so much. God bless you. At this time, the girls' ministry is going to come and they have some presentations. Cheryl Furman is going to come.
Good morning. My name is Cheryl Furman. I'm the Girls Ministries Coordinator. Girls Ministries is a branch of the Assemblies of God designed to disciple girls ages 3 years old through 12th grade. And we meet here on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Our third, fourth, and fifth grade group is called STARS, and they have a special program where if you do all the hard work necessary, you can become an honor star. And I can attest to the hard work that they've done because I was an honor star when I was their age. But the one who helps get them to complete their goal is Miss Sarah Jane, and I'm gonna have her tell you. To begin with, because STARS Club is a 3-year program, it begins with commitment to those 3 years, coming faithfully every Wednesday night as much as you can. I know the girls depend on their parents to get them here, but it requires commitment because we have to complete a certain curriculum, and that takes commitment. It also takes teamwork. These are the STARS Club leaders. Phyllis Root, and I have to tell you that Phyllis makes sure each girl has accepted Christ. And Esther Riverson, faithful Esther. She doesn't have time, but she makes time. Anna Camacho, who has joined us this year. And Angelica, who is invaluable in so many ways. So we're quite a team. We love each other And we love the girls. We love all the girls. Honor Star, our star. They can graduate at 5 levels. S-T-A-R, Honor Star. And I'd like to introduce our Honor Stars. Hope, Malbim. Hope, would you come up? Bethel DeWitt. Once a girl completes all the requirements, first of all, she's a believer and a follower of Jesus Christ. She brings glory to Him through her life. And we build on what you parents build into your children. They also learn how Christian fellowship during Stars Club. They are required to read the New Testament in its entirety. And I don't know if you can see the slide up there, but there's quite a bit that they have to do over and beyond what we do on Wednesday nights. There's just not time to do it on Wednesday nights. So we meet sometimes during the 10:30 church service. Instead of their going to children's church, they meet with me. And it takes months to finish all of the work. The statement of faith is one of them. We learn how to use the harmony of the Gospels to do a study on the life of Christ. And they are so sweet-spirited. It's just such a blessing for me, who only, and I'm glad for my two sons, but I didn't raise girls, and so it's fun for me to work with the girls. They are crap. First they take an honor review in March, which is 3 months ahead of when Stars Club finishes, so they have to do their work ahead of time for that. And we have a women's ministry board of 3 women who give that honor review. And Kay Rash is one, Lois White is the other, and Christy Germain, I don't know if she's here right now. have faithfully done that. And it's a memory test on all of the verses they learned through those 3 years for those units. And they've all done very, very well. So in June, at the annual STARS retreat, each girl is crowned. She's escorted down in the aisle, and they are given a tiara and a sash. And it's just a beautiful ceremony and well deserved. We're just so proud of them. And I'm proud of all the team of STARS Club. We're a team. This isn't a one-person thing. This is teamwork. And it's all because of Jesus we love. So thank you. Thank you, girls. You may have a seat. You can sit down. Oh, I think you say something. I got so carried away. I had asked the girls if they would each say a little something about what STARS Club has meant to them and being an honor star. Renee, you want to start?
Becoming an honor star has helped me a lot to become a better little sister, a better friend, and also to become a better Christian girl, and it just really helped me in my life.
Girls Ministries has helped me in many ways, and it will forever will, because all my teachers and friends have invested their time in teaching me.